它的发音很中国，但是与此同时，我怎么该做是可以老朋友们，所以今天我们来分析一下老番茄中国最大的博主的英语 Ultimate， 我们要分析它的发音、语法还有节奏感，看看它英文到底怎么样。那我之前其实也看过很多他这些玩游戏说英语的视频，我觉得特别搞笑。
Yeah, you have me, I have you。
然后这个就是有一些人给我发过来的，他在复旦大学做的一个英文演讲。So let's take a look how good does this 学霸 sound? How good is his English?Let's go。 那记得如果你想跟我学英语的话，一定要订阅，按一下这个小铃，这样我一发视频你就会收到通知。
Oh, let's get started.
Let's get started. 这个重音感觉就是掌握的不错。
Have you watched a live stream or video clips? By the way, live stream means stream means a flow of liquid or information,and live stream together means 直播。
我觉得其实最主要的就是为什么他会听着非常中文呢？因为是他的发音部位还是比较靠前靠上，就是中文的发音一般就是比较靠这边，然后我们说英文的时候都是在喉咙里这边发出来的。就是你要是听过一美国人说中文，一般来说就是他们就是从这边发音的，然后他们的虽然也会有一些音发的不是特别标准，但是他们都是在这儿发的。然后其实如果有一中国人说英文反过来呢，they speak from here is a very in the front of their mouth， 这个就是一个能暴露出你的这个身份的一个小发音特征，其实也无所谓，就不会影响理解。我觉得其实比这个更重要的是它的这个节奏听着很舒服，我们这一会儿再说。
And when I started making videos, the industry was yet rather small. No one have foreseen that it could grow so far.
Yet 一般就是还没，所以我们一般在口语当中就会说 was notYet very big, was not yet well developed. 他说 was yet.
The industry was yet rather small.
我觉得 yet 可能就是因为受到了什么英音的影响，再加上这个 rather， 我觉得美国人用的比较少一些。我们一般可能会说 it was pretty small, it was quite small, it was very small. 就是这个 rather， 一般来说英国人说的比较多一些。
No one could have expected it.
Could never have expected it. 我觉得这个用法还是比较高级一些。我见过很多人可能词汇量很大，但是不一定是能用这么一个表达，就是这个条件句。So that sounds pretty good.
Well, I wondered why my fan watch my videos. I don't like to watch them. Yes.
我觉得英文比较重要的一个特征就是我们的这个节奏，我们怎么去辨别重要的词跟不重要的词。就是我们一般重要的词发的比较重，不重要的词发的比较轻，而且呢，重要的词之间的这个停顿差不多是一样长的。所以如果这儿有一些不重要的词，不管是一个、两个、三个，这个时长都差不多。它的辅音、元音虽然听着还是有一点点中国的这种腔调，但是它的节奏非常舒服。
I thought about it hard, and then I figured out.
我觉得他 th 这个发的不错的，因为很多人都不会吐舌头啊，可能就先吐舌头，然后发音的时候收回去了，然后说 I thought， 但是他说的是 I thought. He must have gone abroad. I'm like 90% sure of this. Let's go find this word. So it doesn't seem like he's been out of the country, which is absolutely insane. 因为我觉得他的口音真的就是比较英国。我不知道他上学的时候有没有交很多外国朋友，但是 it's really impressive.
It's just like the feeling. We watch chimps. You like chimps? Chimpanzees. Yes? I love chimps.
Chimps.
Oh, I love chimps. I love watching them messing around and...
Mess around 我觉得还是一个挺不错的一个表达，就是他们就在那儿玩，他喜欢这样看他们在那儿跑来跑去。
One, they are behind screens. They cannot hurt us. And two, they act like, oh, I forgot. They are really human beings.
所以他就是说的是主播嘛，主播叫 live streamers 或者 streamers。我不知道他有没有出过国，但是他的口音还是比较像英国的。But he also has some American...pronunciation features, so it's a little bit of a mix.
I have seen really weird things. Many people would
weird,
do anything.
Weird.
I mean,
weird 这个词其实还是比较美国，然后他把这个二吞掉，就英国的感觉，但是听着有一点点不对。在美国我们就会说这事情这个东西很奇怪， This is really weird. 但是呢也有 strange 这个词，我觉得在英国可能更倾向于说 strange.
Many people would do anything, I mean literally anything to get hot, to get popular.
So the people would do anything, people would do literally anything. 这肯定就是 应该是在国外待过吧。 Super native， 他真的就是音标连读弱读省读缩读同化所有的这些发音技巧掌握得非常好。如果你也想学的话，也可以报我们的美式发音学院最新的一个课程，现在有一个大大的折扣，可以到下面的这个链接报名参加。 So what do you guys think， 从一到五分你给他多少分呢？I think his English just sounds really good so far.
Literally anything to get hot, to get popular.
Do anything to get hot. 所以就是为了火嘛。那这个就是应该说 to go viral, to get popular. Go viral, 我们想 virus 这么一个词对吧，就是病毒。所以这个 go viral 指的就是病毒性传播，传得特别火。
You know what? You can't even imagine to get popular.Good-looking women took off clothes.
Took off their clothes.
Weird, isn't it? And weirder. What about
weirder.
Men and women not so good-looking? To get popular.
从句 men and women who are not so good-looking. 这个挺难的。
They took off clothes together. Okay. There's only one case or two cases, but that's not a joke. That actually happened, and these cases have done serious harm to not only the viewers but the society and the industry itself.
那这边我能感觉到他可能比较明显的一个错误，就是他对换词的掌握没有那么的好。虽然他用词特别高级，他的语法结构、句子结构都挺复杂的，但是经常加一些不该加的，或者就是本来该加没有加。And you know that's super common. 我最近其实刚发一个视频，你们可以去看看，一个关于这些冠词应该怎么使用的。Go take a look. But it's things like that don't really matter that much. 其实我觉得语法本身就没有那么重要。当然。你得了解什么时候用一般过去时、一般现在时等等等等，但是这些小错一般不会影响理解。
Now we have a word for such kind of people, web red or web celebrity, 网红 right?
And most 注意一下这 celebrity 发这个 l 的时候呢，我们一定是要注意到舌尖要到我们上牙的后面顶在这儿，就不管是开头的 l、词尾的 l 都是。Celebrity 啊，他也说了什么 web red 就是网红对吧？这个英文知道怎么说吗 ？We would generally say someone is an influencer or an internet celebrity.
You don't know who's behind. It's awkward. It can be awkward sometimes. Believe me, I have experienced two cases. So this time I was at some family occasion, and I hate family occasions.
His intonation is so good. 他真的就是该读重的时候读重了，然后该轻的时候就轻了。It's really impressive.
On my cell phone,
what did he study?
It is so boring. I feel like dying, and when I finish, when I press the send button, just when my fingertip touched the goddamn send button.
When my fingertip touched the goddamn send button.
Yes, I try to act like I'm sociable. I'm mature.And this wingman of mine, wingman,
that's actually a pretty good word. I don't know, I mean, obviously he has the reputation of being a 学霸. He kind of looks like one, but the level of his English is just really incredible.
Some 主播, they keep throwing dirty words through their live stream, and some even drink alcohol and smoke cigarettes.
他是在复旦大学读研对吧? Like, was his degree in English? 那真的说得特别好。
If you...Some dark sides of the industry, the business, it is not perfect. It's even far, far away from good.
惊了。
So, I really appreciate the opportunities you gave me today. And that's not typical speech. That's bad examples for speech. It's more of chatting or talking with you guys something.
听他说了这么多，我就觉得真的就是听着像一个在国外待过的，要么就是交过很多外国朋友的一个人。他用词有很多非常高级的。And it's not like, you know, somebody who memorized a lot of vocabulary. He knows how to use them. 而且是很多高级词汇，还有很多特别口语化的。So, I mean, he must read a lot, he watches a lot of TV shows, 真正的一个学霸，称职的学霸。我这边还得说清楚一点，因为我觉得虽然他的发音很中国，但是与此同时，他所有的元音、辅音都 发的准确，该发 a 的时候发 a 了，该发 a 的时候发 a， 就不是 o 或者 a l。 It's really 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 good. I'm gonna give him 4 points, 因为我觉得他这个发音部位可以往后挪一点点，就会听着更地道。 But it doesn't impact understanding at all. 他的语法我觉得就是他比较弱的一项，就是听到了一些什么过去时都没有使用，然后冠词没用对。 ButThese don't really matter. The most important thing is that you know how to speak naturally. 听他这边讲故事，做这个演讲，真的就是说话特别生动。他知道该什么时候停，什么时候说的比较快，什么时候说的比较重、比较轻。而且呢，他连读也做得不错。但与此同时，说到语法，我觉得他会用很多就比较复杂的句子结构。So I'm gonna give him 4 points again. 发音4分，语法4分，但是他的节奏感。So good, 我给他满分5分。 It was really, really good. That's something that people should be striving for, and anybody can do that. You just need to practice, 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 practice. 每天练习一点点。那今天我们就说到这儿，如果你喜欢这个视频，记得点赞、评论、留言，跟我说一下你自己觉得老番茄的英语怎么样。然后记得，如果你想跟我学英语的话，我们新的美式发音学院刚刚推出，我们现在有一个新的海外学员的一个平台，可以到下面的这个链接。而且呢，我们3月1号开课之前有一个大大的折扣。So, hope you guys will join. If you want to learn English like him, this would be a way to do it. But see you guys soon. Take care. Peace.